Howdy. I think we have to talk about mountain water. We are watching at the International Journal for New Concepts in Global Tectonics, the NCGT Journal. I think I've never pronounced this correctly at the first attempt, except nothing on authority. Volume 11, number 1, March 2023. So a big part of that paper I'm going to show you was made in 2022. And we go down to the mountain water paper, and I won't make a too long video about this. Mountain water. The new approach to mountain forming volcanism or volcanism, glaciers, and the role of water in an electric environment. Abstract. Yeah, that's my paper. I wrote this and I got some help from Bruce Layburn. Thank you very much, Bruce, for this. It was very pleasant to work with you or to get some help from you. Anyway, abstract. People settle near water. Almost all life forms need water. Water is very important for life on Earth. Consensus theory explains the circle of water through evaporation, precipitation, and accumulation. Meteorologists don't know much about volcanoes. Volcanologists don't know much about weather. This is how modern science works. Specialists for every small diversification of whatever science branch. How could anyone within that paradigm ever get a holistic picture of the whole? It is full of contradictions, misinterpreted results, and it also seems to keep certain mysteries alive. Most of them could be more easily understood just by not being ignorant towards knowledge from laboratory experiments and peer-reviewed papers made decades ago. This paper is a thought-provoking new approach to the formation and activities of the Alps and many of its features as a part of the greater environment. It also is meant as a serious warning for millions of people living in the Alps region, which spans from the North Sea down to the Mediterranean and from the Black Sea to the Atlantic. Massive changes in the environment have been taking place in the past, and it is crucial to understand that we are dealing with cyclical events. They are recurrent and will happen again in the future. It is also meant as a serious warning for millions of people living in the Alps region. Serious warning. I will put a link below. You can go and read the whole paper. And when you're done reading, you can go over to my YouTube channel. You will find the Mountain Water, White Rivers, Glaciers, Cryptodomes, Cryptogaziers playlist. That has 365 videos, and after this it might be 366. So if you haven't ever heard about the whole topic, you might need to catch up, at least a little bit. The reason for why I make this video is something that seems to go down in near future in Europe. Yeah, there's many other places in the world as well that experience rather heavy rainfall. The Sahara, for example. But I've been talking about this for a long time, many videos, obviously. So now I want to show you or share with you a video I watched today from Kai Zorn. He is a German weatherman, and I thought I will show you, in a way, a part of his video where you can see how he is usually, or how to say, like, what kind of person or however, that in order for you to get a touch of him within a few seconds. And then he, at one point I will pause and then he will talk about what's going to happen. I want you to take note of how his frequency changes as he starts to talk about it. And it's German, there should be English subtitles. So, yes, with my stuff, what I've been talking about, mountain water, with my try to warn people to be careful because their water will come back. We had the hunger stones some time ago in Germany and in other Central Europe countries. The water of some rivers went so low that people started to carve stuff in rocks that usually weren't exposed or not visible because they were in the river. They were covered by water. But the water dropped so low that they got exposed. And it was a very bad thing. And the people, they were carving stuff like, if you see me weep in those stones and stuff like that. And I said already back then, it is like a tsunami. The sea retreats before it will come back with power. If you go to watch whatever tsunami footage, I think the one that happened in Thailand, there it's very obvious how the sea retreats before it comes back with force. And we are talking about water in general, water in general. I have been talking a lot about water. So now, let's just have a listen to what he says. And remember, like my paper about me trying to warn people. For those who live in the valleys, probably you should figure out something tomorrow or even today already, what you are going to do in the next few days. It might be a wise thing to just grab your stuff. It depends how much you can take with you or how much it's necessary, but maybe it would be a good thing to at least get to some elevated areas that are equipped with infrastructure. Maybe it's not probably the wisest thing to just climb on the next mountain because there might be a lot of snow too. So I don't know. It might be a rather big problem in a few days in Central Europe, but let's just have a look what he says. And about the frequency of him.
Hauptlaufs, der macht auch diese Niederschlagssummen. Das Weiße ist die Mittellinie und unterhalb der Mittellinie sind ein paar Läufe dabei, die bringen so gut wie gar keinen Regen. Das heißt, das ist offen und...
Sorry, I forgot to put the subtitles on. Maybe now it works.
Ich würde jetzt einfach sagen, die Chance besteht laut Modellen 50-50. Aber die Modelle kommen ungern damit klar, was da passiert. Das ist das amerikanische Modell und das ist das europäische Modell. Da haben wir gesehen, da wird ja so gut wie kein Regen berechnet. Wieder der Hauptlauf in hellgrün, der macht, ich bin auch noch da. Der große Rest, zeigt auch diese gigantischen Niederschlagssummen, sogar wahrscheinlicher als das amerikanische Modell. Und auch hier rauschen die Temperaturen in den Keller. Hinten raus wird es ein bisschen freundlicher. Das Ganze für Chemnitz, das ist ja auch in diesem Regengebiet drin. Das amerikanische Modell macht auch wesentlich mehr Niederschlag. Schattiert im Hintergrund sind aber viele Läufe, die das genauso sehen würden, nur wenige, die weniger machen. Und danach würde es trockener und durchschnittlich temperiert weitergehen. Und das europäische ECMWF-Modell hat wieder diesen Hauptluft-Mimimi. Ich bin auch noch da. Und der Rest büxt auch nach oben aus und würde sehr viel Regen bringen. Da kann was im Busch sein. Ich muss jetzt.
So now, take note of how his frequency changes.
Wirklich ganz, ganz vorsichtig sein mit dem allen. Und jetzt gehen wir das mal durch. Jetzt spreche ich mit euch so, als würde ich jetzt mit meinem Nachbarn sprechen oder einem guten Freund und das so erklären. Ab hier ist sozusagen das offizielle Video erst einmal beendet, beziehungsweise unterbrochen. Wir unterbrechen das mal kurz. Bei dem europäischen ECMWF-Modell würde ich sagen, das gibt normales Herbstwetter, es regnet, regnet auch mal viel. In den Ostalpen gibt es eine Menge Regen und in den Hochlagen Schnee. Da wird es auch Schneebruch geben können. Durch die belaubten Bäume ist alles nicht so schlimm. Und die Alpenflüsse, die hier rauskommen, die werden braun und reißend werden und bringen dann an der Donau Hochwassergefahr. Und je weiter wir über Ober nach Niederösterreich und Wien kommen, desto höher werden eben die Wasserstände. Aber das ist alles, ja, im Bereich dessen, was es immer mal wieder gibt. Nicht schlimm. Müsste ich jetzt das interpretieren, da bleibt mir wirklich die Spucke weg. Das erinnert an die Magdalenenflut von 1342, das war damals Ende Juli. Wir müssen nur bedenken, damals haben die Menschen in einer Natur gelebt, die intakt war, wo die Flussläufe so waren. Das hat Ewigkeiten gedauert, bis die mal voll waren. Jetzt leben wir in einer Gesellschaft, wo alles zerstört ist. Wenn diese Niederschlagssummen so kommen würden, wie sie hier abgebildet sind, dann regen wir uns nicht mehr übers Wetter auf. Die Straßen werden weggespült, Brücken werden weggespült, viele Stauseen bringen nichts mehr, weil die voll und überlaufen. Es wird ganze Landstriche wegreißen, es werden die Flussläufe sich neu bilden.
He's talking about dams that will break. There has been a slightly offset translation from Google. He's talking about dam breaks.
Oder sich das zurückholen, was denen ehemals gehört hat, bei diesen Niederschlagssummen. Wenn in der Fläche 300 bis 400 Liter runterkommen auf einen Schlag, dann gute Nacht. Dagegen war 1999 ein Kindergeburtstag, ein absoluter Kindergeburtstag. Und in den Alpen, diese gigantischen Niederschlagsmengen, die hier runterkommen sollen, die kommen da ja als Schnee. Oberhalb von 1000 bis 1500 Meter Höhe und auch inneralpin wird ja einiges berechnet. Und es sind ja viele Alpentäler in der Höhe, zum Beispiel das Paznaun. Das geht da los, Ischgl, 1300 Meter Höhe, Galtür, 1500 Meter Höhe, die schneit's ein. Und dann gibt es ja viele Hütten in den Alpen, die sind ja noch alle bewirtschaftet. Die müssen sich evakuieren. Wenn das.
Anyway, I guess, I hope that you noticed that. Yeah. He has never seen anything like this. So we are probably watching also in Central Europe the returns of the waters, as we have in the Sahara and many other places. The water is about to come back. I tried to find them, but somewhere I have pictures. I stumbled across in Central Europe from some nowadays small rivers or streams. But back in the days, they were using ships and they had ports and all this kind of stuff. And if you go there nowadays, it's just a few meter wide stream somewhere, nothing much to see. A few hundred years ago, there were ships sailing on these rivers. So in other words, if they had ships sailing in Central Europe on nowadays very small streams, we might have to expect that those small streams won't stay small forever. Yeah, that's basically the warning I try to tell many people what might happen in the future. In the not too far future, it was one of the biggest motivation to write that paper. Mountain water. Not only about the formation of the Alps themselves, but also about the water itself that will come from the mountains. Yes. Now it seems that I wasn't too far off with those warnings. And also it doesn't seem that I overrushed with bringing it out, trying to get the knowledge out that be prepared, be aware of the waters returning. Yeah. It seems to happen very soon. And I expect that even though here in Eastern Finland it has been rather bone dry for the most part of the summer, that there will be some issue with water as well going on here. Maybe still this year, maybe next year, maybe in the winter, who knows? Maybe we get 4 meters of snow, I don't know. But it wouldn't surprise me, because the waters will come back. Water, or Earth makes its own water. And if there is whatever energy fluctuations going on the bigger scale, with Earth's electromagnetic circuitry, there's stuff going on the sun, we get more energy, there will be more water vapor, it just will condense more, and then it will rain more, or snow more, or more hail. And if there's more energy, the winds will increase. And so on and so on. And obviously it seems to go down within a few days, at least the first practice of such an event, because I think it would be foolish to expect that after this it's over. Probably not. It will increase, at least almost all of the signs are pointing to that, that it will increase still for a few years before it maybe then just starts to settle down. So if you think like, if this is still going up, like solar activity is still going up, and there might be many things that will take a while, that will go down on Earth after the sun has reached its solar cycle peak and the sun activity will go down, and there might be still stuff emerging from the Earth's interior that are tied to the sun when it still has been active. There will be delays in certain processes because Earth is a capacitor. So it will store some of the energy and it will release it later. And water is one of the things we can see how Earth manages its energy. But anyway, people in large parts of Central Europe, let's take off the texts, in large parts of Central Europe should be very aware of what is coming in the next few days. That's Switzerland or CH, Germany or G, and Austria somewhere here. There are many rivers, and there is the River Rhine, which goes here somewhere. I've been talking about these many times. Check out my videos about mountain water. Yeah, there will be a lot of mountain water. Thanks.